Last week, YouTube released 3 new major updates to the platform that could result in like twice as much, maybe 3 times as much watch time as we're currently getting on our videos, as well as much more exposure and views. Let's talk all about that here today. Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer and it is Tuesday, which means it's time to take a look at some of the online video news updates from last week and talk about what it means for us as creators who are developing our audiences and our platform here on YouTube. So let's talk about these big 3 things. They all revolve actually around reaching people who speak other languages than the language that your video is natively in. The first new feature is the ability to let your viewers create caption files and automatically submit them to your video through YouTube system in any language that they want. But what if you don't have viewers who speak different languages, Spanish, Portuguese, French, German, whatever, or maybe you do, but they're not giving you their time to translate your videos for you? Well, now the second big update is that you can go through the video manager and simply order captions in any of those languages that you want straight through YouTube and then have those captions automatically added back to your video when they're complete. Now, to be fair, both of those features have been in beta testing for a long time. A lot of different creators have been playing with them, but now they are more widely available for any creator to opt in and use. But this third new feature is brand spanking new and it is awesome. So what you can now do is you can now tell YouTube what your YouTube title is and your description is in many different languages. And the viewer, whatever language they speak or whatever country they're browsing from, that is the translation that they will see. So you can have one video have a title in English, have a title in French, a title in German, title in Spanish, and the Spanish-speaking person will see the Spanish title. The French-speaking person will see the French title. And the same with the descriptions. And when they click to play that video, then they see the captions at the bottom in their own native language. Vice reports that on the videos that Spanish and Portuguese-speaking people translated for them, they said they were getting double the amount of watch time on those videos. And on the videos that were translated into Spanish, those are getting triple the amount of daily watch time as they were before. So how does this work on your channel? Let's go to my desktop and walk through it. First, let's talk about the community contributed subtitles and closed captions. So if you come down here, community manage subtitles and closed captions, you'll see you can turn them off or turn it on. I'm gonna turn them on for all of my videos here. It says that they're enabled. This right here is where you can see what you've contributed to other people's videos. So here's the drafts I have of my own stuff. You can also have drafts of other people's in here if you're doing that. But this is where you'll find where other people have contributions that are pending for review for your own videos. Let me show what it looks like. So here's a video of my wife and I. We did our twins baby gender reveal on our family's channel. The way you get to this, you click on this little gear icon, and then you're gonna go up to subtitles and closed captioning, click on that, and then add subtitles and closed captioning. That's exactly what it's gonna be. You're gonna click on that, and it's gonna take you to this video. You're going to select the language. You know, you can search for, you know, Spanish and whatever language. English is what the only language I speak. And then it takes you to the closed captioning setup here. Today is the big day, guys. You know, and so as you stop, and then I can put that adds it there. We're going to find out if we're having boy, you know, and then that hit enter adds it, and then you keep going through there, okay? So then when I'm done, I can submit the saved in my drafts, and so I can either exit, come back and finish it later, or I can just stop here, and someone else can come and pick it up later. So I'll submit this for review. I'll say, everybody's done, no, I'm gonna let other people keep working on them, and submit. And then they'll be submitted, and there we go. So that's my contributions over here that I have added to other people's videos now. If you don't want to wait for someone to do your captions, or you don't have people who are doing it for you in a language, you come over here to click edit on one of your videos, go to subtitles and closed captioning here, and then you can add. I already have an English one published that I've custom made, and that one's all, this video is already captioned in English, but I want to add another one. Let's just say in Spanish. And so this is going to add a new Spanish track here. Here's the option here for by a translation. And the source language, I want to translate it from English. I want them to translate my title. I want to translate my description here. And I also want them to translate my captions. So here's all the captions, the English captions here that they will translate into Spanish for me. So I click next, and I'm going to select Spanish. You can select as many as you want here. I'm just going to go Spanish here for now. And then the next screen is where you're going to pay, and it's, you can see for me to do all the captions and everything, it'd be $142, you know. So then you would go through and check out here if that's worth it for you. There are probably cheaper ways to do this, just by going like fiverr.com and finding someone to do it. What this does, that's the kind of the advantage of this, is you just pay and then they'll automatically push it back to your video and update your video for you within like a few days. 3playmedia.com does that a little bit. Fiverr, you'll have to do it all yourself, but it's definitely the cheapest way to go about it. So let's go back and look at how you can also manually do this. There's a new tab right here on your info and settings called translations. You can click on that, and this is where you can set the original language, which is English, and you want to set that as the default for new all new uploads in my case. And then over here, so this is what people will see in English, but then I could also add a translation. Let's just add, you know, Spanish, add the language. And then here I'm going to enter the translated title. Here I'm going to add the translated description. And again, I could get people, you know, I could pay someone to do this for me through here too. And then save changes. And then the Spanish people will see this stuff, and the English people will see this version for the same exact video. One of the first things that came to my mind is, well, why don't I just take my English title, descriptions, caption files, just run it through Google Translate, and then just add that back into my metadata for my video, and just do that, be a lot cheaper, a lot easier. But the thing is, like, I think the key to really getting people to not only click, but also spend time watching your video, is for it to be a good translation. People can quickly and easily tell when someone just use Google Translate because it's really bad. It's actually laughable sometimes. So that is not a strategy that I will be using. I think what I'm personally going to do is I'm going to take some of my best top performing videos that have proven to be effective and successful in converting viewers into subscribers for me. And I will probably just do those videos at first to see what results and effect that has on the video. But I would love to hear from you guys in the comments below. What other tools do you use? One, are you going to add translations to your stuff? And then three, if you've used Fiverr or other places like that for this type of work, what's your experience been like? And personally, maybe even something like Upwork.com might be a great place to get something like this done for really cheap as well. I think the key is just to get native speaking people that language to do this for you and not robots. As usual, I have several other great links and stories I'm going to share with you guys who are patrons and supporters of video creators. Thank you for making this channel sustainable. And the rest of you, if this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribe every Tuesday. Take a look at the online video news and talk about what it means for us as creators, because I know a lot of you guys, you have messages that need to spread and the world needs to hear, and I want to help you grow your channels and your audiences so that those people can find you, hear your message, and hopefully have their lives be changed as a result. So thank you for letting me be a small part of that. Subscribe, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Bye.